Hi, welcome back. So now you have seen Job Scheduler in concept. Now let's just see a small demo and see that in action. For that, I'm going to create a new application. I'm going to call it my new job scheduler or scheduler and press next. I'm going to use minimum. In this case, you know, Job Scheduler was included in API 21 and it will only work with API 21 or higher. So here you can select minimum as 21 and all your problems will be solved. But I do want to show you that what will happen if you select something which is below 15 also. So let's just continue with 15, but we will solve the problem when we reach there. Press next. Empty activity. Main activity. Finish. In this particular application, I'm going to create a button, and that button will be a toggle button. When you click on that button, your job gets started or your job gets scheduled. And how exactly I will be doing that? I will be creating a service also, which will be extending job service. And in the on start of that job service, I will put a toast. I will just create a skeleton of your job scheduler class. And then once we see how exactly job scheduler works around, then you can always go ahead and design your complex examples also. Let's see. So for that, first I will create a nice UI. I will go ahead and put a text view here at the top and I will call this as, let's say, job scheduler, and I will give some size, maybe 30 SP or 36 SP. Great. Now I will create a button. Okay, I will call, I'll give the ID to this button, let's say my job button. And after that, I'm gonna go to the text part or coding part of it, and I'm gonna call a text off attribute. This will be the text when your button is off, and I will call it job off. And there will be a text on attribute. This will be the attribute when your job is on, turned on. Great. So you can see, right? So I can handle this button with the help of OnClickListener also, and then put a flag by checking it out whether it is on or not. Or I have a listener for toggle button known as isCheckedListener. So I'm directly gonna use that listener. So I will go to my main activity. I need my toggle button. So toggle button, TG. And I'm gonna need the access of this. So how can I do that? Well, TG equals to toggle button. Yeah, find view by ID, r dot ID dot, what was the name? My job button, cool. Now I got the access of my toggle button. What I need is I need to include the listener to this. I can do that by using directly here also. On checked. Change listener. Now, when you do on check change listener, use the compound button on check change listener, and there will be an error. There is an abstract method you need to implement that is called on check change. Press on that. Now, there you go. You have handled also. All you need to do is register your toggle button to your listener by using set on check change listener and put this. Cool. So now what will happen, every time you click on the button, it will come inside this. And here I will start checking if the boolean b, because that's the boolean value you can see here. If the boolean b, that means if it is true, right? And else if it is not true, what you want to do. So when it is true, then when that's when you want to start a job scheduler or want to schedule a job. Now before I start giving the classes for job scheduler, so now that you have handled your button, what will happen when it is on, what will happen when it is not, you just have to put the code of scheduling your job. Now you want to do what? Before scheduling your job, you want to create a job service class. extend a job service class and create a service class. That's where you will be putting all your code, what you want to do with your job scheduler. Well, how can I do that? I will right click on my development package. Either I can go ahead and create a normal Java class and then extend it to job service and then register it manually in manifest file, or I can just go ahead and, okay, service, my job service, my new job, and finish. See, it will extend a service class, but you don't want to extend a service class, you want to extend a job service class. So extend a job service, then in job service, you don't need to override all these things. All you need to do is just click on this first. First, implement the methods. That's OnStart Job and OnStop Job. Once you do that, you will still see that there is a problem here. That is, class requires API level 21. And the current API which we are working on is 15. So what we need here is, there you go. Either you can go ahead in your Gradle file, that is in your Gradle build system, and change from minimum, that is minimum to 21. And sync now. Once you do that, you see, problem is gone. But if you don't want to do that, you want to make it remain this, but at that point of time, you can always go here and add target API or require API. So every time this class is gonna run, it's going to check that whether the particular running device does uses the version Lollipop or not, right? So in my case, I'm just gonna put as minimum 21. Okay, so once you do that, this is where you will put your task. Like what happens when user does come to your service? On start job will be the first one which will be called. So I can put a log here, log.i, and I will call it, let's say, job started. And I will also show a toast, context this, and jobs started. And short.show. Okay, cool. So I will just copy these two statements and paste in these two also, but change the message with stopped and job stopped. Okay, beautiful. Now, once I have this, let's just check about these, you know, let's just check these Boolean values also. If my job would have been a long one, right now I'm just showing a toast, that's fine, then you can put false. But if my job is too long to be shown on your start job, then you might want to create a separate async task class inside your development package, and then create the object of async task class inside this, and then offload that job into that async task class. In that case, you will be putting the true here, and inside that async task class, you have to explicitly call job finished. Here, this OnStop job will not be called until and unless your requirement again doesn't meet, your scheduling requirement are being interrupted in between. So you have to know that this OnStop job will only be called when your requirement are no longer meeting to the requirement which were required to schedule that job. So once you have the service, now I can go into my manifest file. You can see the service is already registered. All I gotta do here is one more thing, that is add the permission. If you remember that we need the permission here, and what kind of permission I need, Android dot permission dot bind job service. There you go. So that's the permission I will be required. And once I put that, okay, my service is ready. Now all I need is scheduling of job scheduler. So first thing first, I need a job scheduler object, my job. And I will be also required job info object, so my job info. Great. So to get the access of my job scheduler, I can just put my job equals to, I will be getting it from system services. So typecast it with and get system services and type job scheduler service. After that, you can put my job. Okay, before I schedule my job, I need to create a job info.builder class to build the condition and to get the to build the condition or constant for my job. So my job builder, so this I'm doing whenever your button is on. Okay, whenever your toggle button is on, then only you want to do that. So here I will go new builder, and inside this there will be two arguments. What is the job ID? So I can put any integer value. I'm going to put one. You can also create a constant at the top and use that constant here. Integer constant. Next is I'm going to put the component. Component is this service class which I have created, my new job. But to get that, I need to do what? Get package manager dot okay, you need to get the component, right? So you can directly get the component by using new component, and inside your component you will put a package name, which package name you are talking about. That is it will give you the access of your package. Second, the job, the class, that is your service class, my job, my new job dot class, and get the name of it. Get name, there you go. Cool. And please be apprised, this statement will only work if you have a API level 21, which I have already declared. So I can be just done with this, but when I run this application, it will show me error because there are no condition defined. There are no constant defined for this particular job builder object. So I need to define those condition here. So what will I do here is dot set, let's say requires charging. True, it does require charging whenever this job gonna be scheduled. So I can put it at here. So that's one condition. To set the next condition, let's just set one more one, that is set required network type. I can put a job info dot any network type, and that would do. And then you want set let's say device idle to require device idle. If you want to schedule this task when your device is idle, well, generally, if you want to put that when your data is, you know, when your job is pretty heavy, by default it's false. I'm explicitly going to put false. If you want it to be scheduled when your device is idle, then put true. Okay, my job builder object is ready. All I got to do is job info object. What is my job info object? My job info equals to my job builder dot build, and after that just do one thing, that is where is your job schedule object? What is your job schedule object? My job dot schedule, call schedule, and just put that what is the job info object? My job info. Yeah, great. So that's when that's what will happen when you check on your job scheduler. Or check on your button, that is toggle button. And let me just, when you turn it off, my job dot cancel, and it will cancel all the jobs. Okay, now let's just run this and see how it goes. If I'm right, yeah, let's just run this and see if my job has been scheduled or not. So when I click on that button, it should show me that toast job started, so I would know that I have scheduled my job. So that's a pretty easy example, pretty easy looking example and pretty trivial example. But you can, once you understand this life cycle, you can always go on and see, job got on, right? So that was a pretty simple example. You can go on and look out for more complex example, but the skeleton, but the framework will remain same, that this is how you will be doing. If there is any job which you want to do, you have to put in the OnStop job. And if it is using any heavy duty work, then you will be needing to use your async task and need to put the true here. And if you want to reschedule it, you will need to put true here again, right? So, and to schedule your job again, you have to put some requirements here and it will be scheduled, right? Now you can see job got started here because, you know, I all the requirements were meeting up. Now let's say I put requires true. Device needs to be idle now. So this time it shouldn't be, it shouldn't get started or shouldn't get scheduled because when your application will be running, your device will not be idle. Let's just check it out. See, there is no toast now. So because the requirement didn't meet, no, it won't really trigger my, or it won't really schedule my job. But once my device gets idle, it will, see that the requirements is on. Job will be triggered. So the job has been scheduled, but the triggering of job will only be done when all your requirements are going to meet. So that was all from my side on JobScheduler. Thank you.